Welcome to VGuy TV. In this video, I am discussing about real numbers part 1. We will discuss few questions of real numbers. See the question. Which of the following have non-terminating repeating decimal? Non-terminating repeating decimal. So you see here, you have to remember A rational number is said to be terminating. The denominator is of form 2 power m or 5 power n. So it means that it is in the form of 2, multiples of 2 or multiples of 5. In that form, if it comes, definitely it will end. If it's not, it won't end. So if you check the number 2 by 25, 25 means I can write 5 square. So it will end. Check this number 2 square by 5 square. They gave it in that form only. So that also will end. Here 6 cubed. 6 I can write 2 into 3. 35. That also it will come as 5. So this number it will terminate. This will terminate. This will terminate. Which is non-terminating in this case? 2 by 7. 2 by 7 is non-terminating, but it repeat and go. Now see the next question. A plus root over a square minus b square by a minus root over a square minus b square plus a minus root over a square minus b square plus a plus root over a square minus b square. If you check this one, if you check this question, just analyze the question, you can see that the denominator in the form of denominator, you check it. This denominator, if you are checking, these two are same, but this is a negative sign, this is a positive sign. If you want to take the LCM, it is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. What is a plus b into a minus b? A square minus b square. So I am taking the LCM of the denominator. A square minus b square. A root over a square minus b square, the whole square. Okay. Then if you divide this term, that is a square minus b square, that is this term, with the first denominator, means this denominator minus is there, right? So if you divide the LCM with the denominator, I'll get an answer a plus root over a square minus b square. That is nothing but the term what is there in the numerator. So that is the reason I'm writing a plus root over a square minus b square, the whole square. Clear? What I told? If we need to add these two numbers, we need to take the LCM. The LCM is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. That is nothing but a square minus root over a square minus b square, the whole square. So this LCM, if you are dividing with this number, we get a term with a positive sign. Positive sign means a plus root over a square minus b square. So that term already in the numerator. So two terms are coming in the numerator. So it is a plus root over a minus a square minus b square, the whole square, plus again this term we are dividing with this term. So we get a term with a minus root over a square minus b square. That term is same like the numerator term. So the numerator term will become square. Clear? The LCM term is this one. LCM dividing with the numerator, we are getting a similar term as a numerator. So that's what square came. This LCM dividing with the denominator, we are getting the same term in the numerator. So that's what square came. Expand it. A square plus a square minus b square plus 2a root over a square minus b square plus this also. A square plus a square minus b square, because this term root will go and we are multiplying this. A square minus b square minus 2a root over a square minus b square. This I expanded in the form of a plus b the whole square. This I expanded with a plus b the whole square. this I expanded with a minus b the whole square. Clear? If you need, you make it like this, so no confusion. Okay, when you square the b, this square root will go. Then if you check this term, how many a square? A square, a square, a square, a square, 4a square. B square, minus b square, minus b square, 2 minus b square. If you check this term and this term, they are equal and opposite, cancel. Denominator, a square, cancel. So your term become 4a square minus 2b square by b square. 2 if you take common, 2 into 2a square minus b square by b square. Clear? So your answer is 2 into 2a square minus b square by b square. So what I did, this type of questions now with identity, we are playing with only identities, nothing more than that. Okay, when you take the LCM, LCM term is in the form of a square minus b square. After taking LCM, dividing that LCM with the denominator, we are getting in the form of a plus b the whole square. What is a plus b the whole square? A plus b the whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. What is a minus b the whole square? A square plus b square minus 2ab. Clear? See the next question. The number 0, 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1. Like this it's coming. This number is called, it is not an ending number. And repetition also you see, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, like that it's going. So I can write it as non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. Non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. Next question. Expressing 0.23 bar plus 0.23 bar as a single decimal. Very important question. I need to add 0.23 bar plus 0.23 bar. I am taking this as a number x and this is y. That is x plus y, equation number 1. From that first number x I have written, x equals 0.23 bar. What is the meaning of 23 bar? 0.23, 23, 23, etc. Now I am multiplying both left side and right side with a 100. So 100x equals 100 when we are multiplying 23.2323, etc. After that, this is equation number 3 and 2. You subtract 3 minus 2. 100x minus x, 99x. 23.2323 minus 0.232323. That decimal part will go. So 99x equals 23 or x equals 23 by 99. Take y. Y equals 0.23 bar. That means 0.233333, etc. Multiply both left side and right side with a 10. So 10y equals 2.3333, etc. Okay. Next term is, you multiply this again with a number 10. So again if you multiply with a 10, it will be 100y equals 23.333. Why we did it like this? Because the number, we need to subtract it and we need to cancel. Right. So first I multiply y with a 10 to take 2 to the left side. Next I am multiplying again with 100. So that's what I get, 23. Then these two number we are subtracting, that is equation 5 minus 6 minus 5. 100y minus 10y, 10, 90y. 23.333 minus 2.333, that is 21. So I get y equals 21 by 90. So I got two number x and y. Now simple, 0.23 bar plus 0.23 bar equals 23 by 99 plus this number, if you divide both numerator and denominator with 3, it is 7 by 30. 7 by 30. LCM is 990. If you add this one, we will get 461. Means 990 divided by, you know that I feel, I did not write that step. 990 divided by 99 is 10. That will come as 230. Plus this term will come as 980 divided by 30 will come. 980 divided by 30 means it will be 33. 33 into 7. 33 into 7 is 21, remainder 2, 23. 2, 3, 1. So that's what 461 by 990 I wrote. What I did? 990 is the LCM. 990 divided by 99. It is 10. 10 into 23, 230 plus. 990 divided by 30, 33. 33 into 7, 231. That is 461 by 990. If you divide this number, we get 0.465, 6565, etc. That is 0.465 bar. 0.465 bar. Okay. The last question. If a number is divided by 6, the remainder is 3. Then what will be the remainder when the square of the same number is divided by 6 again? We have a number, okay? That number, if dividing by 6, then remainder is 3. So it means that how we can take a number? We can take the number by how we will write it. See, we can write an answer by quotient, remainder by divisor, right? This is nothing but the number we are writing. So when you are taking here, we can write here that thing as 6 divided by 6, the remainder is 3. So I don't know the number. So 6 into, we get a number, 6 into Q plus 3, that is your number. Okay. We have some, we get some quotient, right? So we will write it as x equal 6 into, I don't know which number. Which number? That is x. X equal 6 into the answer what we are getting, quotient. 6 into q plus 3. You square the number. X square equals 6q the whole square. That is a plus b the whole square. 36q square plus 36q plus 9. This number, what we are doing is, you see, if you divide with 6, what happens, they asked, right? So 9, I just made it as 6 plus 3. So if you take this number, dividing with 6, 36 by 6 I can do. 6 by 6 is 1. So we are getting a remainder of, what is the remainder? 3. Simple form we are checking, that's all. No big maths and all. We have a number, that number divided by 6, the remainder is 3. But we don't know the answer what we are getting, that I put it as Q. So that's what X equals, the number is X, X equals 6 into Q plus 3. 6 into Q plus 3, Q is the quotient. So we are squaring, because they told to square the same number. When you square the number, I got this. Then they are asking, again dividing with 6. If you divide this with 6, 36 by 6, we get 6. 6 by 6, we get 6 by 6 also we get. This is 3 by 6 we are getting. So 3 by 6 when we are dividing, we get a remainder as 3. So your answer is, where the square of the number, when we divide with the same number 6, your remainder is 3. Okay, so this question you got it, I feel. This one, how to do the recurring numbers and all. Terminating decimal we multiplied, we did. And other one what we did is with the rationalization. And what is a number called non-terminating repeating decimal. I hope you enjoyed the video. Watch our part 2, real numbers. Subscribe our channel, press the bell button so that you will get the new notification when we upload the video. Thank you for watching Week Guide TV. Thank you.